of the Caloosahatchee River and its estuaries have been looking brown and murky. Take a look at this video. It's making people ask what's in the water in parts of Southeast Cape Coral and North Fort Myers. Good evening. Thanks for watching NBC2. I'm Christina Mendez.
And I'm Devin Turk. Scientists are studying a newer type of an algae bloom that's been popping up in the river for the first time in years. But NBC2's Megan Miller found out that's not the only problem. She's at the Marina Town Bait Champ in North Fort Myers talking to people who say that foggy dark water is plaguing the entire marina.
Well, the bait shop has lights where you can normally see fish, even big snooks swimming around. Right now, we're not seeing much here, and boaters who have been out say the fish aren't really biting either. Now, we're also getting some pictures of this brown, murky water, and scientists tell us there's a few different factors causing all this.
So a couple weeks ago, we've seen all this brown, cloudy water.
And today, we could still see brown streaks and murky water from the Caloosahatchee.
Kind of looks like mud.
It has people around Marina Town asking, what's in the water?
Everybody's noticed the brown, clouded water, and it looks like somebody has been dumping stuff from their boats in the water.
Some people actually described it as like sewage in the water.
Caloosa waterkeeper Jod Kasani says volunteers have been taking samples to the experts. They say dumping's not to blame.
Mostly an ecosystem effect that we're worried about now.
Kasani has been working with Dr. Rick Bartleson, a scientist with the Sanibel Captiva Conservation Foundation. He's been studying an algae bloom in the Caloosahatchee. It's called Akishiwo sanguinea, and we haven't seen it here since 2012. And this time, it's been here for about 3 weeks.
It doesn't produce the kind of toxin that red tide produces.
FWC says it can turn the water red and cause fish kills because it takes the oxygen out of the water.
Normally, you're catching 2, 3, 4 fish. Yesterday, 2.5 hours, not a bite.
Dr. Bartleson says the depleting oxygen and high sulfur levels are what's making the water brown and murky.
If you go all the way out, you can see it coming in from the river.
And the nutrients turning the water brown could be contributing to the algal bloom.
They don't bloom unless they have enough nutrients.
Kasani says there's also too much salt in the water right now because of drought-like conditions, and that could also be contributing to the problem. They encourage all of us to report anything unusual we're noticing in the water. You can do that online through the Florida Department of Environmental Protection.